Okay, today we will learn about Microsoft Excel. In Microsoft Excel, the whole sheet is divided into the rows and columns. Vertical are the columns and horizontal are the rows. And the intersection of row and column is called cell. And every cell has its own cell address. Like if I am placing my cell pointer here, the cell address of this cell will be F2, F column, second row. And the cell address of this cell will be G3, G3, because G column and third row. By default, we enter in Microsoft Excel or we use file new option, we always get a new workbook, and every workbook contains new worksheet, sheet 1. In previous versions, we got 3 worksheets, but in new versions, we only get the default sheet is sheet 1, but we can increase the number of sheets by pressing on this button, plus button, and by right mouse click on sheet number, and if we press delete, then we can delete the sheet by right mouse click on the sheet number, and if we use rename, then we can rename our worksheet. Now, I am entering some alphabet. Now, I am pressing some values. Now, you can see the default alignment of the alphabets is left, and the default alignment of numbers is right align. But we can align our text by selecting the text or range and click on center for center alignment, left for left alignment, and right for right alignment. If we want to series the number of series of numbers, if we want to display the number series of numbers, then first we have to click values like 1, 2. Now we will select both the numbers and place your cursor here, and after displaying the plus sign, drag it down. Now I want to display the table of 2. Then I will place starting 2 values and drag your cell pointer like this. Don't drag it from the right, otherwise it will copy the value. So drag from the between position, from the middle position. Now select both the cells and drag it down. It will display the difference between the two cells. It is displaying the difference between the two cells 2 and 4. By calculating this difference, it is displaying the whole values. Now if I am giving Monday, this option is called fill series. First you will have to press enter, then again go to the previous cell and place your cell pointer like this and drag it down. For months, month's name, press enter and go to the previous cell and drag it down. This feature is called fill series. We can increase the width of a column like it, and increase the height of a column like this. Now we are going to the sheet 1. Here I have already created this worksheet. Now if I want to fill the if I want to calculate the sum of these values, then select the range and one cell extra and click on auto sum button. Click on this first total and drag it down. To calculate the percentage, first every formula started with equal to sign. So press equal to sign, and now first total is displaying on F2. So F2 into 100 and if the grand total is 300, then give 300. We can increase the decimal places by using this option, increase decimal places, or if we want to decrease the decimal placing, then we use this button. Now drag it down. Now if I want to insert one more row in this worksheet, then place your cell pointer here, right mouse click and press insert button. Now we are increasing the height of the row. Now I want to merge these cells, then we will use merge and center. I am giving the title to my worksheet, class 6th C. Now it has merged all the cells and my text is displaying in the center. Now select your text, and if I press on this button, then my text will be displayed on the top. This is for middle and this is for bottom. So I am selecting this one. Now we can give the formatting effect to our text. Select your cell, give writing color, change writing size, change font style, select this range and press on center alignment. Now we are also giving the formatting effect to this row also. If I want to give background color to this row, then select your range or cells and give the background color. For writing color, we can use this option, bold. Now we see the output. This is the output of our worksheet. It is not displaying the rows and columns. If we want to display rows and columns, border lines, then we have to use, first select your range, all borders, select this one. For this option, we will use outside border. Now we see the output. Now it is displaying the border lines. Now if I want to add one more column, then click on this particular column, right mouse click, insert. Now I want to add the mark, I want to add one more column for computer, for computer subject. But I don't want to add the marks of computer subject, then we will not use the auto sum function. Then we have to use some other formula, like equal to sign. First value is displaying on C3. So we are giving C3 plus D3. D3 plus E3. I want to calculate only these three cells values. Then it will give only the total of these three cells. So by using this method, you can create your worksheet in Microsoft Excel. Thank you.